Lovely. Over to you.
Cheese.
When you're ready.
Sausages.
Okay, ready? Go! It's open.
Nearly.
What's the role of the council in respect to this park today?
There's a few different prongs here. You've got Andrea, who sort of represents, she's in with my directorate, who looks after parks. She's worked really, really closely with the Playbuilder scheme that was, and with Councillor Curtis, but not with his councillor hat on, with his working with Veolia to secure some additional funding, which has enabled, this is one of now 27 different Playbuilder sites that have been established over the borough, and it's fantastic to see the age range that this different equipment supports. It's new, it's dynamic, it's exciting, and there are kids playing on it already, which is testament to how good it is. So, you know, really, really good work, shows some really good joined up thinking. There are still, I think, two areas that are still having theirs done, and there's possibly still one that we might just be letting you know that we've managed to secure some funding for, which will be really, really good news for the residents. So it's fabulous.
That's the good news. Although we're in leafy Orsett, this whole area of the cricket club hasn't been free from crime. How are you going to make sure?
No. And that's a sad part, you know. If you look around the borough, we do have these hot spots of different areas of, you know, crime. But then is it, you know, hot spot of crime here because a lot more people report it? Whereas if this was in another part of the area that people don't tend to report, is there a balance to be had there? Hopefully most of this stuff should be vandal proof. We'd like to think so. And I'd really like to think that, you know, residents and people that use it and some of the people that, you know, do have questionable characters would like to think that this is their, could be their brothers, their sisters, their cousins, their friends, children's equipment that they will be taking out. Because if it's gone, I have no money to replace it. So, you know, please let's look after what we have and let's make sure that, you know, come the summer, come next summer, we've still got children playing on equipment that hasn't been burned or hasn't been vandalised. Look after it, guys, please.
Mike, you take every opportunity to, in council and out here, to respect the pride you have for your work. So today must be a especially proud day for you.
Well, Orsett is a great place to be, and I have said on occasions it's the best part of Thurrock, but it's better than that. Now it's the best of East of England.
So a play park like this is great to get young people out in the fresh air with families.
Yes,
as well.
And granddads as well.
Keep going, right?
Well, I've been trying it out already, and with my dear friend Charlie Curtis, who's brought his grandchildren down today to come and play on the swings. And I only wish that my grandchildren were here, but when they're here and when they're visiting, this is a place I certainly will come to because they are thoroughly enjoyed.
Sorry. Charlie, seeing play equipment like this is something must gladden your heart.
Very much so, very much so. And, you know, it's Veolia money. I don't know how much longer it's going to last, but we want to make the most of it while we've still got, you know, some of it left. And it's just lovely to see kids and enjoying themselves. And that's what the projects we do with the council, that's what it's all about, you know. Especially in a lovely play area like this. It must be lovely for the kids, and let's hope they get a lot of pleasure out of it.
And not only for the kids, you would hope to see fathers and grandfathers being
here. Of course, well, grandfather's here, my grandchildren are here somewhere playing around, and that's what it's all about. That's what I'm all about. Little payback. I've got six lovely grandchildren, and this is my payback for them.